Good day, everyone. Welcome to the course. My name is Sam. I'm a data science and machine learning trainer. Today, I'm bringing you a very exciting topic about deep learning. As you know, the deep learning is very hot. It's an advanced machine learning technology during the last few years. And today, I'm bringing you how to use the deep learning and the transfer learning to analyze image on your own customized image. This is today's agenda. We'll talk about deep learning basics for image analysis, the real-world image analysis needs and challenges, the idea of transfer learning, and architecture of transfer learning, how to use the pre-trained deep neural network to work on your own images. And we also have a hands-on data lab workshop on the Google Cloud platform. So this training course is around 30 minutes. We'll spend half of the time on the lecturing and half of the time on the workshop. First, what is a deep learning? Deep learning is a machine learning technology using deep convolutional neural network to analyze huge amount of image and classify, find the patterns and classify them into their correct categories. So we have a huge number of images as inputs. Normally there are millions from the image net, for example, and it goes through this magic crystal ball. It will tell you what is the correct category for the images with very accurate correctness. Okay, how this is being done? Let's look at a little bit deeper on the mechanism of a deep neural network. Okay, here you can see on the left side, there is an image here with 2 to 4 times 2 to 4 times 3, which is the 2 to 4 pixel times 2 to 4 pixels, then times 3 channels, which is RGB. So you roughly have 150,000 pixels, or we can also call it features per image. So it's a large number. Then it will go through different layers of neural network. At the meantime, you can treat it, each layer is like a small black box. What they will do here is they will perform called image feature enrichment and extraction based on the pixels. So you can imagine they are aggregated, concentrated, and the features getting smaller and smaller. And here you have a reduced feature of 2048. So basically, they transform all the original pixel information from over 150,000 data points to a reduced 2048. Then again, it's further concentrated into 100 classes. See, that's the category that we want the neural network to predict. So these 100 classes, you can also think it is some kind of feature. And this one feature, one out of the 1,000 feature corresponding to a particular category of this image. So maybe it's a cat, or it's a dog, or it's a car, it's a truck, as we can see in the ImageNet data collection. Okay, so it's so exciting. I want to use it for my own problem domain. So I have a real-world image analysis need here. So assuming now I'm a data scientist working in the industry. In my workplace, I have some images of healthy working valves. So these two are healthy, although this one looks very rusty, but it's still considered healthy and functional. And I have some more functional ones, abnormal. So this is some steams leaking, and this is some, some kind of leakage here. So you can see there's different type of valves in the field. So the shape, the color, the type are really different. So I like to explore the promising benefit of automatically monitor, classify, and tell me when some problem happens to the valves. I want to get an alert. Well, but I'm facing some challenges. A lack of powerful computing resources, as we all know, deep learning requires huge amount of computing power parallel, but luckily it is solved by the non-ops Google Cloud platforms. And I also have problems to design the neural network architecture and 2 million of parameters of the deep neural network. So there are so many layers, so many hidden hyperparameters to tune. I don't have that luxury to tune it. So last and most important, I lack of enough labeled images. As we can see, training a deep neural network requires huge amount of image data, but I only have 100 or a few hundred. It's so small that the neural network will not be able to train on a small data set. How can I do? But I still want to explore the advanced technology. Is there a solution? Yes, there is a solution. We call it transfer learning. Let's look at the idea of transfer learning. So as you can see, we have a task of using ImageNet data to correctly predict the 1,000 categories of the images from the ImageNet. And we have already built a very accurate deep neural network here. So let's look at what are each layers of the neural network do. So each layer of the neural network actually consists of many called detectors. Those detectors try to look for a specific kind of pattern on the image. So for the detector at this layer near to the image, they may look for some diagonals, look for the color change of the image. So they are very small. They look for very focus on very small areas, and they look for very simple patterns. So this is this layer. And when the layers getting accumulated, the features propagate through the network. At a later stage of the neural network layers, we see the detectors are getting larger. They are looking for larger patterns. There will be corners, there will be larger patterns, and stripes, it's windows. So it looks for a relatively larger area on the image. And at the final stage, we start to see, well, those local detectors start to look for objects, larger patterns like human face, like a bridge, flowers, part of the flowers. So the idea here is the later the neural network layer, the more specific that local detectors used for a specific, very specific task. And here is what we want to find, 1,000 category for the ImageNet images. But for those earlier detectors, earlier neural net layers, those smaller detectors are more generic. Let's say for the diagonals, you look for some edges, which is very generic. Any pictures and any objects in a picture generally have certain kind of patterns like diagonals, like the color change. And this layer, it seems also good. Right, they are also looking for patterns on a relatively generic way. Well, okay. How can we use the transfer learning technology? So this is a way to do it. First, we have seen for task one on ImageNet, we have a pre-built neural network. The later part, or we call on the top layers, is very specific to this task one on the ImageNet. So we don't want to use it. We want to get some features and local detectors more generic for my own task two, valve problem detection problem. So a few valve pictures here, and the raw feature is still the same. There are 150,000 pixels here. Then this part, we will cut to the second next to last layers to obtain a features called deep features. We will retain these model's parameters unchanged, but we chop off the last part. And we treat this part as a called feature extraction and transformation. To get the concentrated deep features representing a representation for each image. So how can we understand here? Yes. For the deep features, you see there's 2045 data points per image. So this is actually like a concentration process. We concentrate the over 1050 features to only 2048 features. By doing this, we greatly reduce the data dimensions, the complexity of the image, while at the same time we still maintain the core and the essence, which is distinguishable between the image, between the raw images. So there is an example here. Imagine instead of the valve images, we have a human here, a few humans here. We want to evaluate the overall wellness of an individual human being. Then we know for a particular human, we have their weight, we have its height, and we have their salary income. We also have their credit card spending. So we consider these four features for a particular human, and these four features corresponding to four pixels of the image. So the analog is here. Then imagine if the feature of the human being goes through this feature extraction, we get some deep features of that particular human. Imagine for the height and the weight, it can be transformed and concentrated into only one feature. That will be BMI, your body mass index, which is a combination of your height and weight. So we have one. And for your salary, your income, and your credit card spending, we can say these are your financial health index. So we give the number to represent two features, income and spending. So now we have transformed the four features of a human being to only two index features, and these two index features can be considered as deep feature. So the feature extraction here, what it actually performs is to concentrate and find the most distinguished patterns from the raw image and reduce the dimension of the input feature to a reduced number. You can see the concentration ratio here is very good. We basically transformed from 150,000 to 2,000 plus. By doing this, we are actually greatly helping the following simple machine learning models to learn. Okay, once we obtain the deep feature of the images, what we only need is to train a simple machine learning model, which is less time consuming and it's pretty standard and easy ways in the machine learning world. So we just get one of the simple model, linear regression or support vector machines, to predict whether a valve is normal or is abnormal. So this is the whole process of how to do the transfer learning. Okay, now let's move on to the hands-on data lab workshop. It sounds very exciting, but how can we do it to apply the transfer learning on my own images? So in this lab, you will carry out a transfer learning example based on Google Inception version 3 image recognition deep convolutional neural network. So Inception version 3 is a name for that deep neural network of a particular structure. You will learn to explore the valve images in the customer's industry, reposition a pre-trained deep neural network for new image recognition task, perform feature extraction to obtain the deep features. So once you obtain the deep features, representation of the customer's original image we can train a simple machine learning model for the new type of classification task, which is deciding whether the valve is normal or abnormal. Last but not the most important is we want to evaluate the results of this overall transfer learning model, how accurate it is, how to evaluate the performance. That's very important. Okay, let's see how we do it. To access the Datalab workshop, we log on to the Google Cloud platform to start the Datalab. Then we download the notebook from the GitHub repository. Then we go to the notebook and follow. Okay. First, log on your own Google Data Cloud, Google Cloud. Then go to the Cloud Datalab. Okay, I've already started a Google Cloud Datalab. If it's new, you will see nothing is there. So first thing is, let's create a notebook. Create a new notebook. And we want to run a command here, which is git clone here. Okay, we copy it. And we paste it here. So it will download the repository content into this new data lab, Google Data Lab. It takes around 1 minute to download it. Okay, we can see the download is completed, 100% done. Okay, now we go back to the folder here. You will see this GCP sample here. Okay, we open this, a new tab. We can close the notebook that we are not going to use it anymore. If you are picky enough, you can delete it. You can delete it. So we will no longer use it. So you go to this GCP sample, you will see lab notes in the, you will see the notes, the PDF in the notes folder, and then our lab is the workshop, right, the notebook that we are going to follow. Okay, you can see the note image analysis PDF. This is the lecture note you can download and use. Okay, how? Now we are in the lab. In the image folder, we have all the valve images, abnormal and normal valve. There are some reference we will go through in the notebook itself. So let's open the lab image analysis. We'll open this. This is in the image folder. So you have 100 pictures. So having a 15 normal valve and 15 abnormal valve. Okay. Okay, now we are in the lab. So this is image analysis lab. So our purpose is to detect normal or abnormal industry valves using transfer learning technology upon Google's pre-trained deep neural network. Its name is Inception-3, version 3. So the use case here is to use drones to provide regular surveillance to remote and dangerous areas, capturing image of industry equipment like valves, pumps, and then stream the data back to our automatic more function diagnosis, then using the machine intelligence. This improves safety and efficiency compared to the current human involved process, which is some areas remote and risky. So without large investment of very wide sensor infrastructure, because drone is very flexible with the camera. So the core part of this solution involves advanced image analysis in real world. So in this lab, you will carry out a transfer learning example based on Google Inception-3 image recognition network. So you will learn to explore the image, reposition a pre-trained deep neural network, perform the feature extraction, and so on. So let's go on. So first step, let's explore the image in the customer's industry. So we can see these are a few normal valves in the plot. So these, they are having all different shapes and the different sides. And some of them, although it looks pretty rusty, however, it's still working. So we see some abnormal ones. Oh, this is some steam leakage. Here, there's some liquid leakage. And this one, some problems happen. This is not very obvious, but it's considered as abnormal. Let's see the performance of this transfer learning model. Okay, we have a quick look on the Google's Inception version 3 deep neural network. So each node here, you can treat it as black box at the moment. Each node here is actually a layer of neural network we have seen earlier. And you get the results here. So we have downloaded this pre-trained Inception model at this place. If you want to re-download it, you can do it, but we already downloaded it when you are downloading from the Git repository. So the second step is we reposition this pre-trained neural network model for our new image, valve image recognition. So first, we import a few libraries. Here we can see the TensorFlow version is 1.0.0. This is a new version that we are using on Google Cloud. And next is we see, oh, there is number of image 100. They are in the library of, in the folder of images. And we store our model, which is this pre-trained Inception model, in this reusable model folder. Okay, next, to use the TensorFlow, we should define a graph that represents the description of the computation. So we won't go to that depth at this course, and we simply define the graph. The purpose is to calculate the deep features by reusing part of the pre-trained deep neural network. The third step is now we perform the feature extraction. Okay, to do so, we retrieve the next to last layers of that Inception V3, and that layer is called bottleneck pool 3. Bottleneck pool 3. Imagine this is your neural network. We want to chop off here. We disregard the last layer and we only obtain these layers to generate the deep features. And this layer is called bottleneck pool 3. Okay, next is we define the following functions to generate the deep features. And also to generate the deep features for our new set of image, which is the valves, and their corresponding normal labels, whether it's normal or abnormal, based on their file names. As we can see, the file names here is starting from abnormal valve 01 to 50. Then for normal valve is normal valve. And we use that the file name as the category. Okay, we continue to run using Shift and Enter. Okay, it's completed. So step four is we want to obtain the deep features representation. We basically recalculate by using the raw image, the pixels, as an input, and we want to get a transformed and concentrated deep feature representation for each individual image. So this process runs for around 1 minute. Okay, we'll give them some time to complete running. Well, we can see the deep feature extraction has completed successfully. Next, let's have a look at, okay, we have processed 100 images and the unique image classes, the labels is normal and abnormal. This is a two classes, the binary classification problem. Next, we have a look at the number of deep features per image. For one image, the number of deep features 2048. So the question here is why 2048? Recall what we have learned in the lecture. An image's deep features representation, so there will be a few real numbers. and this is, there will be 2048 numbers per image. Okay, for TensorFlow, it requires the label, the class name, to be a number. So we do a small transformation. We transform the normal valve to 0 and abnormal valve to 1. So you see this. Okay, then the features and the labels can be saved. So next time we don't need to rerun the above pretty slow deep feature generations again. So we save the deep features, the labels we created. And the next step is we need to train a simple machine learning model will work for the new classification task. We will use the deep features we just calculated to train. So here is, now we are at this stage. We have obtained the deep feature representation of the raw image. And now we are training a new simple machine learning model to classify it whether it's normal valve or abnormal valve. Okay, first, we prepare the training set and the data and test it. So we'll use 75% of the data for the training and 25% of the data for the testing and the prediction of this model. Okay, so now we'll classify the image with a simple TensorFlow linear model. So we'll choose a simple ones and classifying to a binary classes. So we see there are some machine learning models pattern here is, first, for estimator, we define a simple learning model to use. Here we use a linear classifier. Then next is we estimator fit, dot fit is all normally used for training the model iteratively based on the input data. Then after that, once we obtain the model is now installed in the estimator. So there is a method to perform the prediction is dot predict. So we use that training model to retrieve the prediction for the unseen and the new valve image or the test image. So this is the step we will run it. So we first define the estimator, which is a linear classifier. Then we fit it using the deep images, deep features for training and the class labels for the training to train it. Then after that, we predict it. So the predicted one will be stored here using the deep feature of the test set. Okay, now we will run it. Okay, there are many information for TensorFlow, which is pretty good for you to understand a little bit deeper on what the TensorFlow is working. But now we are very interested in, oh, it's already finished. So it tells you TensorFlow machine learning model completed successfully. And next is, well, we want to see how good this overall transformation model performs. So we will evaluate it. So there are several ways to evaluate. The most straightforward and simple way is to see the accuracy, how many number of image that we have classified, predicted correctly, which is correct abnormal, is correct abnormal, and how many that we get it wrong. So let's have a look. Well, we get an accuracy of 92%, which is pretty high. Over 90 is pretty impressive. Well, and we haven't done much things to it. We only use a simple training, simple machine learning model, which is a linear model. But and we reuse part of the pre-trained deep neural network to perform the feature extraction to prepare the inputs for the simple classifier. And the results is amazing. 92%. There are other ways to evaluate the model using confusion matrix. So we'll see what are those normals that will predict abnormal and what are those abnormal that will predict normal. So here is, we have a look at the confusion matrix here. Okay, for that, these two columns represent actual class. Okay, the actual class for those abnormal ones, and we predict, this is a prediction class here. For the actual abnormal, how many we predict abnormal, which is number of 8. And for those normal, we predict normal is 15. And for those actually abnormal ones that we predicted as normal, which is wrong, is 1. So these are those called false alarms. Oh, sorry, these are called those missed alarm. That it actually is normal, but we think it's normal. And this part is the actual class is normal, but we predicted as abnormal. So this is 1. 1 means this is a false alarm. Actually, it's working pretty good. Okay, so since we have two problematic wrong bad predictions, let's have a look at those file images with we incorrectly diagnosis. Okay, these are the two. So this is the actual normal valve, but we predicted, the model predicted as a abnormal one. There may be reason this is looks pretty unique. And this is an abnormal valve with some steams here, and our model predict as a normal. So this is a missed one. So this is how a entire transfer learning model works. So we have a takeaway question here. Is there better ways to further improve the prediction accuracy? Yes, there are. Actually, you can find more from our more advanced Google Cloud Platform courses. Stay tuned. Well, congratulations. You are now equipped with practical skills to work on real-world image analysis problems, and you have learned deep learning basics for image analysis, real-world image analysis needs, the idea of transfer learning, which is very powerful, and you have a hands-on data lab workshop on GCP. Well, thank you for viewing this lecture. I hope to see you next time. My name is Sam, the data science trainer. Bye-bye.